Now, Laban is the spokesman for this family. Will you listen to him? And Laban and Bethuel answered and said, "The thing proceedeth from the Lord. We cannot speak unto thee bad or good. Behold, Rebekah's before thee, take her and go, and let her be thy master's son's wife, as the Lord hath spoken." They said, "As far as we're concerned, this is of the Lord, and you go ahead and take her." But now notice, it came to pass that when Abraham's servant heard their words, he worshipped the Lord, bowing himself to the earth. And the servant brought forth jewels of silver, jewels of gold and raiment, and gave them to Rebekah. He gave also to her brother and to her mother precious things. Now, this is the way the Spirit of God does. We have the earnest of the Spirit when we come to Christ, and being justified by faith, we have peace with God, we have access, we have joy, we have a hope, and we have the Holy Spirit. These are the wonderful things that have been made over to the believer today. Now we're told here in verse 54, they did eat and drink, he and the men that were with him. And they tarried all night, and they rose up in the morning, and he said, "Send me away unto my master." And her brother and her mother said, "Let the damsel abide with us a few days, at least 10. After that she shall go." And the very next morning, this servant said, "I want to be on my way. I tell you, this is big business for him." And the brother said, "Why? What's your hurry? Give us at least 10 days to tell her goodbye, but after all, we better talk this over with her." And he said unto them, "Hinder me not, seeing the Lord hath prospered my way. Send me away, that I may go to my master." And they said, "We'll call the damsel and inquire at her mouth." Now we've come to this very important part of this that I think's quite wonderful.